while about the brand, how it has been coming up. The brand was started in 2007. The exact date was 777 when we started the brand with two stores, one in GIP Noida and one in today's mall in Rajouri Garden. And since then, I think it has been going good. The journey has been so far good. And we are now with 160 point of sales in the country, which is across Pan India. 45 are exclusive EBOs and 120 shop-in-shops. So we are available in good large format stores like Central and Capsules and things like that. And what I can say about the brand, that the whole idea to bring Kazo into amalgamation is that it's very much connected to the today's women of India. So the women of India should have been very bold, confident, and should feel, girl means for me, a lady who is 40 years old should feel 30 years old after wearing Kazo product. That's the analogy behind the brand, right? And so far, I think the collections have been very much appreciated from our consumers, and I hope that this collection also brings a very good excitement among the people and who are going to consume them, as well as, of course, you guys can tell us any opinions you have, right? Even if it is not cool enough and you have a better idea, you're more than welcome to tell us. We always look forward to get it better and better each time. So as you can see, there have been some different highlights of the products here, and how we are trying to do this year to change the collection is that we will be launching the collections in the stores every week. Every Friday we will be launching something new coming up. So that's the whole strategy and coming up, going forward. That's all, yeah, sure.
I just want to know where and how did you come up with the name Kazo? What does it mean? Where is it from? Because I have, my name is Dolly, guys. So I get intrigued with names. I need to know where, because my parents didn't put any effort into my name, so I just need to know where Kazo is coming from.
That's the most frequently asked question from me, right? And the answer is that it's just a name that you said, right? No effort on the name, so, but I think I put an effort on the name here, right? So I wanted it to be a name which is very catchy, smart, and connect to the personality which was looking in my eyes. This is how the Kazo girl should look like. So the brand Kazo was actually registered before it was launched, 2 years prior to that. So I knew in back of my mind I'm going to launch a brand one day. So I registered three brands, out of which finally when the day was supposed to be launched, we then choose for Kazo. So it's the right one. The two, one was called Magic, starting with Kazo. And the other one was called Young.
I think Kazo is, because Magic and Young, I'm not very sure, but Kazo sounds really cool, because I think Kazo is also very timeless. It doesn't matter, it's just a word, right? It's just a nice sounding word. So I think that was a good choice.
Yeah, and going forward, you will see in the coming collections, what we're doing in December, January, we're going to do a big launch of the brand Kazo t-shirts in a big way, because we got a lot of requests about branding t-shirts. So, so Divya is working on that, so probably you'll have a lot more to see in the future.
Okay, well then I'm going to take the questions to Divya later on. But thank you, Mr. Deepak. Thank you for. Is there anything you want to tell us about this collection in particular?
I think besides I saying anything, it should be the people here. They are the new generation. They are the collection. Because we have done our job, so I think they should judge us. So
it's your job now to judge the collection.
Correct.
Give the points that you must give, and it should be good. We're not here to listen.
You guys are finding it interesting so far. The collection, whatever you've seen.
Is the collection good?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'd love to hear that.
Alright,
we'll elaborate on that.
Alright, oh, clarifications are happening. Alright,
yes,
go ahead.
Yes. So, yesterday I was writing my write-up about my profile, and so she over here was working with me on it, and I was like, okay, what all do I do? So I started listing it down, and I'm like, I think we should cut it off, because anyways it's going to sound like nepotism if I'm listing 2-3 things, but we should keep it short, otherwise it's definitely going to sound like nepotism. So, yes.
And okay, but she's a serious one, she's studied for it. from Parsons, New York. And so she has all the eligibility for to be what she is today. And she's done this whole collection, this beautiful collection, and she's going to tell us about it now. So Divya, what is your inspiration behind this collection, which the theme is retro nostalgia? So what is it that you're bringing in with this collection? Where is the inspiration coming from?
The inspiration behind the collection is that we want to refocus and redefine the stage of being purposeful with contemporary magic. And in the past, Kaz was known very strongly for party wear. So with this collection, we're trying to come into the market with a stronger foothold on casual wear and work wear, and of course. At the same time, we're not going to lose out on our party wear, so we're focusing on party wear, of course, in a big way. But again, we're focusing a lot on the new trend of work wear and casual wear as well.
Okay, so I can see all the blingy party wear also here. But what's with the workwear? What is there anything new that you've come up with? Especially I heard you have a casual workwear also, like a more young.
When I say casual wear, we're also focusing on, we don't want to give you the casual wear that you get in any other brand. We want to give you casual wear that is a little more upgraded than any other brand that we're offering you. Be it a little fancy trim or a fancy button or a fancy tape. It just has to be a little more upgraded than the normal thing you would find in the market.
So, can you tell me about what you're wearing right now? And what is it that you like the
most? How do you know this is Kazo?
Of course I know it's Kazo. You're representing. I'm wearing Kazo. You made me. Alright, tell me about the outfit that you're wearing.
So, you see a lot of people doing cold cut prints, but this is our interesting take on coffee. I call it the coffee bean print.
Yeah, it is actually. It's not really
a coffee bean, but it looks like a coffee bean to me, and it's similar to the coffee color. So, it's very body flattering silhouette, I would say, because it's turning in on the body and it puts up.
It cinches your waist, accentuates your top off. Guys, do you have any questions regarding the collection that you all saw? I would love to have some questions to me or Divya or just about the collection in general. Is there anything you guys have? Because, oh yeah, please.
So I was wondering why I
mean,
it's like any jeans that you like bootcuts or necklines.
So we actually were not doing denims before, but good that you asked. In February, we launched our first denim collection, and we will be actually launching our second set of denim collection somewhere in September. It's actually still in the designing phase. We've almost finalized the design, but if you want, especially, I can definitely take it through the denim collection. That's something we haven't focused on before, but it's a product category we have recently launched. We'll also be doing some denim jackets and some lightweight denim, so that's a new category we've added.
And we have something to watch out for. The denims are coming.
No, but I mean, if you want to talk about new, we try to do a lot of new things every now and then. So in first week of August, we're launching we're calling it the Neon Arrivals, and it's going to be a limited edition collection, only available at select stores. And you can have a sneak peek into the collection over there.
I think everybody is obsessed with neon, so we're going to wait for that collection to hit the stores. Any other things that you guys might want to ask, maybe about the neons? Anything that you want to know? I also saw that your animal prints are kind of, you guys have redefined it in a way that it's much, like the colors are different, it's much bolder. Why did you guys do that?
So I think animal prints is now becoming an evergreen trend. It's going to last a while. But again, we have seen so much because that's something they want. But we want to give them a more interesting take on it, like something different. Animal print, yet with maybe with a different color tape, or like maybe something like this over here. We have Leo print with flocking detail. That's not something that's common. People are usually using print as a printing technique on fabric, but this is the fabric itself is animal print.
You want to show us?
Yeah.